Hello everyone, welcome to Black Arrow Gaming. I'm Bob, and this is the ninth episode in our Age of Wonders 3 co-op strategy challenge. In this series, I'm joined by Evan. We're taking on 6 Emperor Computers, 5 Remain. Here's a view of kind of what's going on in the underground. So at the end of the last episode, at least from my perspective, I had 2 main things going on. Underground, you can see my purple army here moving down towards red, the Halfling Necromancer, who's causing some trouble down here. I intend to hit this city, SWAT sec, and then move on to Yardakry. I think that's how you pronounce that. So that army will see some action pretty soon. Above ground, Evan and I are both making a push towards White's island city here. We can also see he controls that mermaid dwelling out west of it. This will be our second go at capturing and holding the city, but with these units, White should not be able to kick us off this island very easily. So at the beginning of the next turn, I think, do you want to try to land on the... Oh wait, we can't land on the beach. At least I can't. One of your armies could.
My armies could.
Both of them could? Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Mine's the only one that couldn't. So how about we stay in the water and make a little triangle closer to their island? Or you could land there, and I could run my army more to the east of it. Yeah, you should go ahead and land on the beach. I'll sail down the channel to the east a little bit, where we're less likely to run into a bunch of his stuff. Although I think in either case, we should wait to do that until after White has finished his turn, so we don't have to worry about anything jumping out and getting us. My lost soul here is just kind of on his way to go help with casting Undead Plague on this city. I'm just tormenting the Draconians with that. These armies down here are kind of on hold for the moment. This one really needs to heal up more, but I don't have time for that. I want to get red now while his army at this city seems to be a little vulnerable. On that note, I can scout ahead with my Griffin Rider and see, just to make sure there's nothing behind him that I haven't seen yet. And there is. He has a lot of backup in there, which makes me think that I need to bring a few more units down, maybe, and give this army a chance to heal more. With how badly injured those units are, they really need... Well, does my druid have anything that could help? I have Nourishing Meal, which would help a little bit. Kind of want to keep the druid with his own army, though, so that he can give them the... Yeah. No, what I could do is I could switch the two heroes. So my druid can help a little bit with healing. There we go. That'll work for now. I'll switch them back once my units have had a chance to heal. And I need to bring more reinforcements down. Now, my Theocrat should do really well against that army, but he is only one unit. So I have to keep that in mind. This city here is doing very well, but right now I am upgrading it to have the Altar of Bound Souls. So I need to keep a couple units back there on defense. For the time being, I can afford to send this Griffin Rider down into the caves, at least on the next turn. I'll probably leave at least one behind in case those animals show up, and I'll send some of these other units down into the caverns to kind of help. The Griffin Rider won't be able to actually enter the caves unless I move another unit out of the way, which I can do that at least. So I move my hero to the side, send the Griffin Rider in, and then move the Griffin Rider right away. There we go. Griffin Riders have a lot of health, so they could take a little while to heal. Put that archer on camp for now. And that's all I really had to do to finish up this turn. Just needed to reposition a few things. Alright, are you ready for the next turn?
I'm ready.
Alright, here we go. So I believe Evan's going to try to get his arm. Go ahead. What were you saying?
Didn't say anything.
Oh, I thought you did. I'm going to wait to see what White does, but you might want to move your army into at least your druid army into a triangle formation before White sails.
Really don't. I would rather they tried to attack and get slaughtered than put him in a good defensive position and scare White away.
Yeah, that's probably true too. Yeah, it looks like they're kind of running anyway. Alright, don't need to worry about that. So the next quickest thing I need to do... Whoa. Oh, crap. Well, at least these guys are attacking this army and not... Ooh, dang. This is going to be a... I forgot they had that really strong group of units out there. I'm going to have to use magic to win this battle, which is going to prevent me from casting Undead Plague on the city that I wanted to on this turn. Okay, so Stiffen Limbs doesn't do me a whole lot of good in this battle unless I cast it on a non-flying or floating unit, because while it will reduce their defense, units that float or fly don't get the movement points taken away like it would for a walking unit. It said probable victory for this battle, but I think I'll be okay if I take advantage of spells like this. I'm going to cast it on the Shock Serpent first. Since it's an AI, or an independent enemy, it can't be disjuncted. Probably will cast it on the Blight Tusk Boar too, just to hopefully keep it out of the battle a little longer. And let's see here. I'm going to try to lure these Shock Serpents in. Preferably to attack the... Griffin Rider with its extra first strike. That would be good. Make sure my other units were safely out of range. So, and then I'll probably leave the Tigran out in kind of a flanking angle right here. See what he does. Okay, not surprising they would do that. Okay, they're kind of wasting some of their turns here. Alright, that lesser air elemental is... It has projectile resistance, I think. But I also have fire damage on this sun spear. So I could kind of go like this. Get a flank attack. And then I can actually go like this and charge it too. That thing has a lot of health though. Wait, no, not really. The cadavers do poison damage, which that thing is apparently immune to. Feathered serpents don't have any sort of projectile resistance, so archers will tear them up fairly quickly. And I think with a flank attack from this thing, we should finish that off. The other feathered serpent is right there though, and I do want to be careful to avoid letting any of my units get stunned. If the cadavers die, it's not really a very big deal. But if something else dies, like the Griffin Rider, or perhaps even worse, the Reanimator, that would hurt. Tigran Sabertooth Chariot is a tier 2 unit, so the Reanimator could revive it if it needed to. Where he's standing now, the Reanimator should be okay. But to be on the safe side, I'm going to move it a little bit further away, just to guarantee that that Shock Serpent can't get a flank attack on it. The Griffin Rider I will leave on Actually, you know what? The Griffin Rider can move here and then go on defense. It might get hit by several things, but it's very unlikely to get stunned by those snakes, and it puts that serpent in a difficult position. Oh, of course the serpent has sprint. I forgot about that. Okay, not a huge problem. I can come back from this. In fact, I might get out of this battle with all my units intact yet. They took out the cadaver, and they took out the longbowman, but I can revive both of them. The saber-tooth chariot can finish off that lesser elemental unit, but... Oh, I guess I just need to be careful what order I do this in. Because of the where the boars and the feathered serpent are positioned and the fact that my griffin rider is out of movement, I'm worried about that situation. Fortunately, the boar, they do have stiffened limbs. Now might be a good time for me to consider casting another spell. Siphon Life is a good one, and I think that this would be a useful situation to use it in, just to give my griffin rider a little more health back and damage the boar a bit. I don't really have a reason not to kill the air elemental with that Tigran, so I'll just do that. And instead of attacking anything with these reanimators, I think I'm going to just use them to get that cadaver back. I'll place him on defense and see what the enemy does. Okay, looks like I'll get out of this one with everybody still alive. So what I want to do now is reanimate my archer and use it to get a shot in the back of this feathered serpent, which turns it around, leaving it vulnerable to attacks from my cadavers and from my griffin rider. Now I'm not sure if I'm going to use the griffin rider. It depends on how well this unit will fare against the boar, and it looks like it'll fare pretty well. Especially with 100% light protection. I want to reposition my cadavers here in case the Griffin Rider doesn't finish this thing off, but it really should. Okay, so a probable victory, a probable defeat, and I end up not actually losing anything, simply because of that reanimator, which is really good news for me. I shouldn't forget about Undead Plague, which apparently I can still cast on this turn. I must have been really close to casting it before. The Draconians moved that flame tank out there, but it wasn't able to reach my lost soul, which is good for me. Allows me to move a little closer to their city once the game catches up with whatever it's doing. Are you stuck?
Looks like it.
Oh wait, there we go. Must have just been computers acting. Okay, there we go. Got Undead Plague. So that helps me out a little bit. And then I'm gonna send these lost souls up and out of here. Or maybe down. They don't actually have another city. Oh wait, they do have another city over there, so yeah. I'm going to go down with this group. There we go. Okay, back in my capital city, I still find that I have a need for archers, so I am going to build probably two more here. Even though I am going to be replacing many of them with better archers from this city, I'd still rather have some to help me fight now. I'm going to move this unit here and then try to get it on the land quickly at the beginning of the next turn. Actually, better for me to move it here, because then I can get within range of the city on the next turn once Evan moves his orcs.
Do you need me to move?
So, on the beginning of the next turn, I will need you for your orc armies that are helping me attack this white... Actually, there's only one unit in that city. Your units could just bum rush it. Well, basically the army with three shock troopers is in my army's way, preventing me from getting to that city in one turn, because I'd have to go around them. So I would need you to move that army with the shock troopers so I can make a straight line towards the city at the island. This city out here really isn't doing anything that important. Probably going to use it primarily to generate merchandise until I can spare units to clear that ziggurat, but I'm not really in any hurry to do that, because I already have the city down here can produce pretty good reanimators because of the Forbidden Sanctum. Evan killed some stuff in a lost library back in his own territory. He's kind of clearing out a lot of the structures in his own land back here right now. Things that have been left uncleared for a while, just because there are more important things for his armies to be doing. Alright, Torshor, my orc city that Evan so kindly gave to me earlier in the game, is getting very close to being able to make some pretty good units, specifically orc shock troopers. I think I need... Have I built an arena? I believe I did build an arena in the last episode because I needed to... Yeah, I needed to build something cheap. The Dark Citadel costs 300, but I can actually afford to build that, so I'm going to start doing that now. Now, up here in my dwarf city, I almost forgot about these guys. I need to be doing things with them. Didn't build them just to sit around. So, I'm going to start by sending them out this way. Clearing, actually, this structure doesn't really do them any good, but maybe I'll get lucky and find something nice to buy in here. I do need to do this battle manually, because this isn't a particularly strong army.
Go ahead, window blast. I woke up to it.
Alright. With those Frostling Ice Scapers there, I want units, and Harpoon Throwers, I want units that can resist their damage kind of up in the front. The Axeman's gonna be my best bet with its shield. And the cavalry probably could follow up behind it just because they're sort of tough. One thing to note about this group of units that I have here is that none of them have magic. I do want to keep that Frostling, that Royal Guard away from my cavalry units if possible. So I may put a pikeman on that side where he is. Another cavalry sitting a little further back. I did forget to have my crossbowman shoot at somebody there, though. That was a mistake. Okay, now preferably I would like to kill the Royal Guard with the crossbowman, without getting any other units too close, but that's not really going to be an option. Somebody's going to have to take a hit here, so I can go at it from behind with the Royal Guard, and maybe, just maybe, no, not quite. I will have to hit it with something else. Let's see how much damage I can do to these other units, like these Frostling Harpoon Throwers, which have just run right in front of everybody. Well, the Axeman can actually go after them and get a flank attack. Oh wait, no. It won't get a flank attack. That's fine. I will use my cavalry to deal with them. Build up a charge first. And then just slaughter him with the cavalry. With this guy moving around, he can get in the Ice Scaper's face and hopefully prevent him from doing anything crazy. In fact, he has defensive strike. So what I can do is I can defensive strike on the Royal Guard, leaving him with just a little health and putting me in defense so that when I shoot it with the crossbow, it doesn't hurt him as much. Alright, he absorbed that hit fairly well, all things considered. Now I want the Deep Guard to go and just get in the Ice Scaper's face and stab it a couple times. That's nice, I have lifesteal on it. And the only unit left is this other Deep Guard, which should have no trouble with this Frostling Raider. I can just put it there and put it on defense, and I'll have a huge advantage. lifesteal, that thing doesn't have a chance. Alright. Oh, it's still there. Couldn't even see it. I'd prefer to give, well, the only unit that can hit it is going to be the crossbow. Alright, now, you'll notice here in a second one notable problem with this army that I didn't really think of ahead of time. There's no healers in it, so I have to rely on things I built in my city to heal them. I think the Embalmer's Guild that I have might, or the Harvest, no, it does not. I have to build the Embalmer's Guild. Evan took out just a wandering cannon. He's kind of making a push at Red's capital there. Hopefully the extra pressure will make Red take some units away from the city that I'm trying to attack, which seems to be by far the most heavily fortified. Speaking of that city, I need to get a reanimator down there to help with healing. I also need another reanimator in this city to help this army with healing. However, this city at least has an Embalmer's Guild already, so any units on it will heal by themselves fairly quickly. Let's see how they're doing. Yes, definitely want another reanimator with that group. I'm thinking I'm going to take this Griffin Rider out since it's so close to having full health, if the reanimator can even make it there on this turn. We'll have to find that out. And he just can't. Just barely can't. Alright, I'm going to split this army up because I want some units back here to kind of keep an eye on this city. The Griffin Rider and the Archer would be good choices. Evan took out some more animals underground. I believe that was either an animal structure or a wandering group. Alright, and he got something else too. Wandering Naga unit. Probably leftovers. There's another one down there I'm sure he'll go get shortly. Leftovers from the Naga that used to own this city in the underground. He's kind of moving that army south through this area, hoping it links up with mine eventually, but he might be better for him to explore more southeast, see if we can figure out where, well, for one thing, where Teal is. That's kind of important. Alright, so back what I was saying here. Want the Griffin Rider in that city, at least one archer, and probably... You know what? I'm gonna say those two themselves should be okay for now. I really want the rest of this army down going towards the underground. And then I can start sending another archer towards the city to help hold the wall. Should be okay. I don't imagine I'm going to get jumped by anything anytime soon. So I could build an Embalmer's Guild in that city. It's probably faster than building a Necromancer's Dark Tower and then building a Reanimator. It definitely is, actually. Although, not really as convenient. I'm going to have to wait for the production to finish on that. In the meantime, there's not a lot that this army can do with how beat up they've gotten. So I'm going to have them hold off in that city for now. I should have thought of that as I was building that city, thought to make reanimators first. One of the disadvantages of being an undead or a necromancer, I suppose. Alright, I got my lost soul out here. I get necromancy 4 on the next turn, which is going to let me cast Undead Plague in a single turn. So that's going to really help me out in terms of growth. And I think I'm going to use it to go after this city down here, kind of where my lost soul is going into the borders of. This might be a suicide run for him. Orange has a fairly significant army of boats out here. He's got a flyer, a couple of cannons, and two heroes on the water near this other island that's kind of southeast of me. They're not far from where Moldan is. I had to keep an eye on that. All right, well, with me getting ready to cast Undead Plague on that city, I may as well start casting it now, because I will have enough casting points to finish on the next turn and have a little leftover magic. Maybe just enough for... I think I might actually end up being one short of being able to cast Stiffen Limb, so it might not matter anyway. Alright, and that's it. I need to be ready to do that quickly on this turn. Got it off. Now I need to see if I can get this guy away. And maybe I can. Got him onto the land at least. We'll see if anything chases it. Again, declining peace from these guys. Not interested. The Fairy City Underground has wants open borders with me. I'm gonna check my alignment before I say yes or no, and I definitely don't want to make friends with them. In fact, if anything, I should declare war on them just to get my alignment closer to neutral. I'll keep that option in reserve. For now, I'm still technically neutral, so it's not a problem. But I'm definitely not going to make peace with them. Okay, Necromancy 4, which I just got, is a pretty well-rounded... Having 60 as a Necromancer is a good, pretty well-rounded spot to get to, I suppose, in terms of how many casting points you have for level. So I might sit here for a while and try to get some other good spells. If I research this path, the Produce Bone Collector, I can move closer to getting Deathbringers. I'm sorry, I can move closer to getting Dread Reapers. And I think that having them, especially if we can take out the other Necromancer, will be really nice. The only thing I'm worried about is the Theocrat. And from we haven't seen any of his units yet. I'm actually more worried about him than anything else. With that in mind, I'm going to actually take the other route here and start trying to get the Chthonic Guardians and the bonuses for the Grey Guard, because I think those would be really helpful in fighting against a Theocrat. The problem is that I don't really know how to get there, because none of these spells are any Grey Guard spells. So I'm going to start with getting something like Dispel, maybe some of these Avatar spells, and hopefully that'll open something up. Alright, back in Moldan, I do now have the item that gives, or the structure that gives, support units resurgence. Make sure there's nothing else I can build, but I don't think there is. Not really. Yep, so I'm going to go ahead and make probably a couple more reanimators, and those two will have resurgence, so that'll be really nice. I need to remember to put this city probably on infinite produce merchandise for now. I can't imagine there's anything else I'm going to do with it anytime soon. It looks like these guys did heal a little bit of their health in this city, so maybe necromancer units do heal a little bit, as long as they're garrisoned in a city. Evan easily wins a small battle clearing out another Magma Forge in his domain. And got a Destruction Node too. You can see how much stuff that's giving him. It's giving him all that happiness, plus 5 research and I think 15. It says income plus 10 mana, but I think it's actually giving him 15. It probably tells me what I would get if I controlled it. At least with a little pop-up tooltip. Anyway, leaving these guys here for now, and just realized the reason this one's healing is because he's not a ghoul. Those two both are not ghouls, but the other ones are, and they will not heal until I get that Embalmer's Guild built here. That was an interesting battle. Evan just slaughtered a couple of poor little mermaids, or a mermaid and a mariner. A bunch of galleons. those ships are going to be nice if we can get them kind of around the map. Although, there's not really a way for him to get them. Well, I guess there is. Where we really need them is in this ocean where White is. That's where they would be most helpful right now. But it would take him, like, literally forever to sail northeast all the way around south. There is a path to get there, but it's a very, very long and inconvenient path. And I don't think there's any way to slip him through. Well, actually, he could go through this river route, which would be a little less... That would require going past the enemy a little less. Where are you? What route are you planning on taking those ships on?
I haven't decided yet.
Alright. Because the problem is, by the time they get into the lake where these frostlings are, we might not need them there anymore. Okay. I should be able to take this city out. Are you going to leave your orcs on the water?
I have to run them back.
Okay. I'm going to try to capture this city then and hopefully hold it for a turn. White never turned it into a not ghoul city. Maybe they didn't have time, but I thought they really did. Anyway, this should be a fairly easy battle. The question is, can I hold the city once I have it? It's just a couple shamans and a tier one animal unit. Just a little snake, which should die pretty easily. I can be a little reckless with these unicorn riders. I can be aggressive with them if I need to, because I do have the option of reviving them with my reanimators. And in fact, my king has a revive option as well. Looks like they're going to hold their ground, but this unit seems to be a little more off by himself than the others. So I'm going to use the unicorn rider to begin opening a gap in this gate and send some longbows over here to start shooting him. That thing has frost bolts, which my unit should resist pretty well. Frost protection of 40%, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem for them to handle. Actually, I have two groups of archers here, which is going to be nice for defending the wall. And I'll just have everyone hold ground there for the moment and see what happens next. Barely does any damage to my king. Although he is chilled now, so I have to take that into account. Chilling, I believe, makes your unit more vulnerable to frost damage. Yes, and minus one defense. I could try to befriend that animal, which might not be a bad idea, because my king does have that ability. Oh, target cannot be affected though, because it's a druid and as such has beast mastery. So their animals have mind control immunity. I think that I can probably... I really want to light up those archers, but I'm going to have to... Or light up those shamans, but I'm going to have to kill this snake first. Just before it runs in here and hits anything, causing problems. I think my necromancer, my reanimator, can finish it off pretty easily. Yeah, I would have to absolute min roll this. I'm going to say that won't happen. Okay, it just barely didn't happen. It did just enough damage to kill that. Alright, I'm gonna get a little aggressive here. Get a good flank hit on them, and my king can come up from behind, probably killing them, but instead I'm going to use the bow and inflict enfeebling fever, and I can use this unit to go over here, since I don't have to worry about that ice really at all because she's a frostling. She can get that out of the way of my king and give him a clearer shot. Still not quite enough to kill it, but the longbows can finish it off. That leaves them with one shaman, which will do almost nothing to me. Give the archers a little experience. My king could do some healing here. This rogue didn't even take damage. And she should have backstab, yep. So she could do quite a bit of damage to that thing. I was trying to think if it's worth making a cadaver, and I don't see how it would hurt me at this point. So I'm gonna revive those snakes. I wasn't really paying attention to which units had a higher rank. I maybe should have revived that shaman instead. Dang, that thing held up pretty well. Won't matter though. Okay, so that deals a decent blow to White. We get that city back, but he's still got the bulk of his army out in the water. He's got some of it rushing Evan's city. So Evan's gonna have to do something about that. They might make it there before he does. No, maybe not. Evan's unit should be able to reach them on next turn, if they move quickly. Now that I have the city back, fortunately, it seems to have not really been phased. It's still under my control, it's still undead, and it's still elf, so... the first thing that I want to do is build a wooden wall. My archers need something to shoot off of. And not enough money to do it on this turn, so I'm just going to leave that queued and have everyone else kind of hold ground here. The reanimator should really go with the cadaver, but this turn nobody has any movement left, so... they're just going to have to deal with it. I can get my archer a little bit closer to Moldan, and on the next turn garrison that with an extra unit, just in case something shows up. This army down here is starting to look a little better. Could still definitely use some more healing, but I can at least let a few more units down to join this group. I might actually be going overkill here a little bit. I think I have more than enough units to take this city, but I'm waiting for them to heal anyway, so it's not really a disadvantage for me to hang around. I can shift everyone a little bit closer, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Put some pressure on them. Okay. He's got three full stacks in there, but a lot of them are units like Lost Souls that aren't very tough. I think it's going to be best for me to attack on the next turn before he builds walls in there, to be honest. So I'm going to move a bit closer. And on the next turn, my unit should be healed up enough to be able to launch that attack and do a pretty good job. The Lost Soul somehow did not get attacked out here. They really should have taken them out. I'm going to start sending them towards this other city out here. In the meantime, because I don't have anything else to do with my magic on this turn, I am going to summon more Lost Souls. Probably this group I'm going to summon underground so I can help Evan with some exploration down here. I could also start summoning Banshees, but right now I just want another scout. This city, I had ordered two longbowmen, so I'm going to send another one kind of down towards the front lines. And then leave the last one in there. Okay. Should be a fairly significant battle in the underground on this turn. Evan did catch up to White. Okay, Evan won a very important battle against White here. Took out a fairly powerful army, which included a tier 4 unit, as well as their main leader, their hero, or their queen. So, that leaves White kind of vulnerable right now. Unfortunately, we don't have a way of getting to their throne city fast enough to knock them out of the game, but that will at least slow them down significantly, and should give me time to build up defenses at this city and actually really take control of it, so that I can start making some really good archers. Hopefully sooner rather than later. Also, White did the courtesy of clearing off some of these structures for me, so when my borders expand, I will get all those bonuses. That's something that I would not have been able to do with this army. At least not very easily. I apparently lost that cadaver that I got the turn before this one. I don't know where that went. I thought that had more health. It shouldn't have decayed that quickly. That's odd.
Was that the snake that you turned into a cadaver?
Yeah.
I wonder if the beast mastery means you can't take control of it. After it dies or something.
It does. I do remember reading that. That's correct. That would be why I don't still have it. That's happened to me before. Oh, crap. Red is... Whoa. Oh, I just got outplayed hard. Oh, that's not good. Okay, it's okay. I think I can handle this, but... Okay, so... I made a rush at Red City, and he just abandoned the city and went for the tunnel entrance and got on top of it and has three stacks sitting on top, so I can't get this army back up. But what I think I can do is throw together just some really powerful units led by my Theocrat that all have spirit damage. Might be able to take out all three of those stacks because there's not really any good units in there except for the Eagle Rider. There's just a ton of lost souls. Alright, I think I've got this. I think I can do this. Somebody's trying to disjunct Undead Plague. Let's see. I only benefit from this with melee units. So who needs to be in this battle? I'm going to say I want the knight. That devastating charge. Definitely want at least a couple of Griffin Riders. Preferably ones with full health. Make sure their health's at full, okay. I don't need archers for this battle. I don't plan on using them much. I want that Dire Bear in here just because the bear is awesome. And he should get, yes, he does get the bonus. He just does a ton of damage. And probably gonna top it off with another Griffin Rider. Yeah. He has 71 out of 71 health. Prefer to take one that's more promoted, so I'll take this one with 84 health. Nice.
I did not get a Kraken.
Heaven cleared
items.
Heaven cleared one of those whirlpools. As his navy continues to move up to go somewhere. Alright, I do need to remember that I have Lost Soul to cast, and I'm going to cast that here. Right next to that hero. And I'm just going to run him northeast. Because this is the direction I'm more concerned about figuring out what's in the underground. Because if there's stuff underneath an area that's pretty much behind me, well, there's nothing over here, that's a dead end. That's something I would need to worry about. Trying to decide if I should go after this army here with these units. I think what I'm going to do is move the Necromancer up with them so he can heal somebody, so that going into the next battle, I've got that extra healing. I've got that extra health. That's an Ice Scaper. I could attack it with an entirely separate army, but nah. I think I'm going to use them to go after the city itself. So I'll have the Necromancer join them. He can at least help. By Necromancer, I mean Reanimator. Okay, well, I'd rather have them hitting him, that's fine. I don't really want this army over here to take much of any damage. We'll see what they go after. Move him over here so he's in range to heal something if he needs to. Okay, so the bear is what's taking all the damage. They've left themselves fairly vulnerable to flank attacks, so I should be able to kill them. Oh yeah, one shot. Yeah, easily. I can flank them over and over. Make sure I don't take a hit there. And make sure the bear gets health. I'll let my king get the finishing hit on this guy. I don't think I can convert that, no, because it's undead. Alright, so that army can go into this battle with absolutely full health, which is what I wanted. This is going to be a little crazy. Oh, wait a second. That's not how this works. Maybe that was an earlier version of Age of Wonders, I don't know. I thought it would bring all three stacks in, but it actually only attacks the stack that's on top of the cave entrance. I had no idea. I could swear that worked differently. I was totally wrong about that. Alright, well, that's fine, I guess. That makes things easier for me. I probably don't need to bother being too careful with these guys. That knight's gonna devastating charge whatever it hits. Oh, not quite. Bear wrecked it though. And this unit is gonna go right there to prevent that other one from getting flanked. Waste their turn by devouring a corpse. Giving my bear a promotion. And I don't want all those lost souls to pop back up, so actually fairly easy to prevent that from happening. This is just me min-maxing my experience here, but because I can get a little an extra weapon on that unit, I can prevent it from, or I can get a little extra XP for my hero, which I think is always worth it. Okay, now I would have to fight two stacks though, but I'm actually feeling pretty good about that. This army should really destroy these ones pretty hard. It says closely matched, but I don't feel at all threatened by this army. In fact, this is really only six units, and they're split up. Okay, I'm gonna start by lighting these things up a little bit. Whoops, well, that's not really what I wanted to do, but it doesn't hurt me. See if I can draw that one into attacking the Griffin Rider. And leave this one out here in kind of a flanking position. Whoa, they went hard after my king there. I left a vulnerability. Wasn't looking at that Griffin Rider like I should have been. Still, not really a problem. I'll use the bear to get at that. That ghoul halfling eagle rider is actually pretty tough. I should be very careful around that. What I'm going to do is use that unit to turn it around, then use this unit to turn the banshee around, which frees my king up to pretty much obliterate whatever he wants. And I'm going to do just that. I didn't quite kill it though. But my Griffin Rider, well, yeesh, it could still hit my king pretty hard. I need to cast a spell or something. I'm worried about losing my hero on this turn. Of course, I can't siphon life from anything. And Death Ray won't hurt it much. In fact, Stiffened Limbs won't hurt it either. I can't do anything. I think they're gonna kill my hero here. No, they didn't. They could have, though. Huh. I think I just got lucky. Yeah, I did not fight this battle particularly well, but I'm going to get lucky anyway. Alright, who's on my side here? Do I still have all my units? Yes, I do. Alright, I can get the knight around back behind these units. I want to go after those ones. Of course, I can't heal myself. And I can't do anything to them either, other than kill them in one shot. Okay, so that takes out that group, which turned out to be a tougher battle than I thought, because I underestimated that Eagle Rider. It had 100 health, so it turned out to be a lot tougher to kill than I thought. But anyway, it ended pretty well for me. Since this army is just really good at fighting the Necromancer, I'm going to keep them down here in the underground and push against Red, because I can only assume he's got more cities behind this one.
Does. One I found down in the south there is Red's, like south of the lava pool.
Oh, Ferric? Yeah. Okay. That's where I'll probably go next with this army. And I might split off some units to go deal with that other Tigran city that I found to the west, which was that kind of beige pink color. This army definitely needs a reanimator in it, though. Probably two, but I'm going to need to split them up and have them go with other armies as well. Well, I can just move these units up and take that city pretty easily, and send one reanimator their way. Probably send the druid too, so he can lead the army. And then I can take these units and go after this little group right here. That's actually got two Eagle Riders in it, so I'm going to bring down some backup. That's kind of what they're here for, I guess. And I'm going to split off a unit that doesn't really need healings. I guess the bear would be the best one. These guys can hit these haste berries and then get to wherever they need to go. So they can join in this battle too. Just really wreck these guys pretty hard. Alright, that works for me. Who needs to launch the attack? Send a unit with more movement. Now, I do need to be careful with my hero in this one because I don't want him to die and his health is pretty low. And they're all running that direction. This unit could hit that with holy magic and do pretty good damage, unless it gets lucky. I need to prioritize getting one of those reanimators down to help my hero out. In fact, I'm going to run my hero to the reanimator for that reason, and just leave him on guard. That should leave these units without too much to threaten them while they deal with these other units heading their way. I think that I could rush the halfling with the bear and probably kill it with one hit. But to be on the safe side, I'm going to use the knight. because of its devastating charge ability. I can also kind of prevent them from flanking that knight by doing this. Whoops. I should have left a unit over here. I forgot I had that other Eagle Rider, or the other Griffin Rider back there. These units, I can move them up, but I want to make sure they don't get hit by anything on this turn, because if that army turns around and rushes them, that army's a lot weaker, so I want to avoid losing any of them. And I actually had another Griffin Rider out here. I'll just put it over here for now. Wing beat, not really a big surprise. Okay, I can sneak these archers up on it. I want to leave room for my other units to get through. That Tigran should do a significant amount of damage to it. But I'm going to hit it from the other side with this unit, my hero, which should come pretty close to killing it, if not. Yeah, there we go. I can still eat the corpse of an undead unit. So I can heal my cadavers a little bit. And probably just put this guy in defense, maybe in a position where he can attack that hero as soon as he can. Okay, with this Halfling Eagle Rider in my face, this thing needs to go. My knights got beat up pretty bad, so I want to be careful with them. I don't have any other units with healing. I'll probably just get them out of the battle. But the bear has plenty of firepower left. I'm going to avoid taking any unnecessary damage by just hitting it once. That allows me to retreat my knight. And then I can just kind of continuously flank this with more powerful units. Build up my charge bonus. And that one can actually kill it. Now I can put some pressure on the hero. Get a couple more flank attacks in. Should leave him without really very many options. In fact, it looks like I can kill it. Quite get there with that unit. Swordsman won't reach. Longbow won't reach. But both of those units have first strike, so he really can't do anything. So with that in mind, I'm going to use this guy to give a nourishing meal to my knight. Heal it a little bit. Alright. Let the hero get the experience for this kill. Okay, and that pretty much wipes out Red's whole attack force over here. Which should leave them fairly vulnerable for me to run an army down and go after them. With how many units I just killed, I'd feel pretty confident running my Theocrat army in his direction by itself. I'm gonna have to make sure I get a reanimator in there to help heal. I almost need two with the amount of damage they seem to be taking, but at least one. In fact, that one looks like a pretty good candidate, so I will remove a Griffin Rider, probably whichever one's the most damaged, and add him to the group. And they can make a little bit more progress and just start heading that direction. I think I'm going to leave it like that, because the other army is going to need a reanimator too, and I have maybe another one. I can reinforce this spell. I'm going to do that. I have another one that just produced up here that I'm going to send underground, since they're very desperately needed down there. Can also add another archer to that city, buff its defense a little bit, and decide what I'm going to do with this halfling undead city down here. I kind of want to look at the structures around it, and I realize that can migrate to dwarves, elves, or orcs. And it doesn't have any sort of structures around it that really benefit one race more than all the others. So I guess it could get pikemen with that ancient ruins over there. So I would want to decide who has the best pikemen. And none of those races really have pikemen that stand out that much either. Yeah. I'm just going to absorb it as is. Maybe having halfling technology will, for some reason, be useful at some point. I was thinking about migrating it to get the evil points for making a city migrate, but that actually doesn't factor in if the city is undead. So I wouldn't get any evil points for migrating it anyway. I'll stack whatever wounded units I have with this other reanimator that's out here. Or as many of them as I can, anyway. Try to keep the cadaver alive, too, if I can. Alright. And I'm gonna send that army, or start marching that army, back in the other direction. Oh, just realized there's items sitting here that I did not grab. See if there's anything good. Just a bow, but that's not necessarily bad. Let me see who could really benefit from that. My king already has one. I'm going to give it to my Tigran Rogue because she's with my king's army and they're going to be defending a wall if white shows up. That seems like a pretty good place to put it. And those units just can't quite catch up with everybody else, but I'll make sure they do on the next turn. This seems like a pretty good spell. Healing Essence. If there are corpses on the battlefield, they will be destroyed and all friendly units will instantly be healed for 10 health. It actually is maybe a little bit of a disadvantage to me as a necromancer, but it might come in handy at some point. And it's a Greyguard spell, and since I'm kind of trying to go the Greyguard route right now, I want that. My hero leveled up again. I'm running out of abilities that really benefit. Ooh. Except for Holy Champions. Yeah, I'll get that since I'm about to charge a Necromancer. That just gave all these units in this army Holy Champion on top of the spirit damage that they're already doing. This army will wreck that Necromancer. My capital city I'm going to put back on produce merchandise, probably infinitely. I don't think there's much more I want to do with that city. And the Orc City's Dark Citadel will be done on the next turn, so that's pretty good. And dwarves are stuck here for now. Just keep skipping their turn until they've got their health back. I suppose my other Lost Soul could try to help me cast Undead Plague on Orange's capital, or Red's capital city. That's probably what I will do on the next turn. And I'll probably take those haste berries and run. My other lost soul over here is kind of going over towards this city on the coast. And I'll cast Dread Plague on that too when I have a chance. But I can only do it one turn at a time. Okay, everybody's good where they're at. And we can probably get one more turn in here. That was a unusually long turn with all of my battles. That army is healing quite slowly. You know what? I am going to throw an extra reanimator their way. I think they could use it. Because I have that other one coming down from the surface that'll be able to help my other group. And just to keep it kind of a nice balance of units, I am going to send the Griffin Rider back with this army. That way he's got one of each of a tier 3 cavalry type unit. And then they should be able to just really do some damage. Getting chased by a ghoul frostling. Oh, whoops. Do manual combat here and run from this thing. If I can. In fact, it should be pretty easy for me to. They're not exactly the fastest mounted unit. It can be helpful to run them around through obstacles like this. Hopefully they go the north route. They did. Oh, they might catch up to me. Ooh, just barely. I gotta cast Undead Plague really fast after this. Oh wait, I can't cast Undead Plague. That's a capital, or that's a necromancer city. I need to get these guys out of there. Oh, and they discovered something useful. Draconians are sending their a small navy my way. Well, I have a backup city I can cast Undead Plague on because I've got this lost soul over here, so I will do that. And then run before those flyers come after me. Which, actually, they can't because they don't have enough movement points left. Get a little bit more of the territory explored by floating along the coast. And then I can just have them wait. Those flyers may try to chase me down, so I should try to remember to move them quickly on the next turn. A sorcerer just showed up. I like that. I'm going to say not now because I can't pay for it on this turn. But on the next turn, I will definitely pick that up. Especially with an army moving this direction. That would be a great thing to do. I want another reanimator here. I seem to be short on healing, so I'm going to keep making those. And he desperately needs to join this group here. Evan took out a quarry, continuing to clear structures in his territory, and there are a lot of them. Probably beginning that ancient ruins momentarily. I finally got an embalmer's guild in this city. Going to go ahead and build the necromancer's dark tower and at least start moving towards something that would get me necromancers, so I can actually make this city useful. The embalmer's guild healed almost all of my units entirely. I could use a well of souls to turn them all into undead, but for now I'm just going to have to deal with the fact that a couple of them are not going to get any benefits from that. And I can take out this structure. This is probable victory, but I feel pretty good about my odds, especially having two pikemen in this battle. And especially because it looks like they're just going to charge me. I'm going to back these guys up and let those knights come running right into their spears. Alright, we'll see which one they decide to go after. That guy, that's fine with me. Should be able to hit these guys pretty hard. Yeah. With lifesteal, I think I got almost all of my health back from that. These deep guards have no movement left. get a defensive strike in on him, flank him again with the crossbows, and can't quite kill him with the boar rider. So may put those units on defense. What other options do I have here? With those halberdiers coming, I definitely don't want to run my boar riders out in that direction. That should work. I'm going to make sure that he can't get hit by anything, but leave him there in case he needs to get out and flank something. Okay, they went after that deep guard. But I can turn him around at least. And I have really now a lot of options for hitting these guys. Here, can hit him with those guys, but I'm actually going to use them to hit this unit. Can hit this one from over here and finish it off with that one, and I think not, can't quite finish him with that unit. I can't quite finish him with my deep guard. They might kill the deep guard off. Nah, they killed the crossbow. That's alright. I can build another one, replace it pretty easily. Besides, once these things finish clearing off these structures, they won't have a whole lot else to do. Pyromancer's tinderbox. They're mediocre rewards, but I'm sure somebody could use that red raptor. Somebody disjuncted Undead Plague. Which city was that? Okay, well, I can get a lost soul over there pretty quickly. Alright, let's see. What was I doing up here? Right, I need to decide which hero would get that red raptor. I need somebody who doesn't have a mount already. I'm about to get a new draconian hero soon. Let's flip underground here and see what everybody has. Tiger and Druid has a spider, the king has a bear, the rogue has a red raptor, and that guy has a red raptor. So pretty much everybody has units, or has a mount. I'm going to leave one of these guys here that isn't an undead. Yeah, I like that one. Send the others back towards the city to heal. And I can give that to her on the next turn when I actually buy her, if I have enough money for it. Torshore just finished its Dark Citadel, so I can build slaughter pits now and get close to making shock troopers. Alright, Evan took a Frostling city. Oh, he's bum-rushing their capital. I didn't think he could get down there that fast. How much longer before their hero returns from the void?
I don't remember.
It doesn't seem to tell me. Evan may be able to take out that Frostling on the next turn. That would be awesome if he could pull that off. It would take a tremendous amount of pressure off me down here at this lake. Anyway, back to Torshore. I'm going to want slaughter pits, I think. Then after that, I should be able to start making some shock troopers of my own. That will be really nice. was going to have that reanimator join up with one of these two armies. Honestly, both of them need it. But should probably prioritize this one for now. It's got a little couple higher tier units that need more healing faster, like the Griffin Riders. And I will send another one down to join these guys. I think with this army, I'm actually going to use that to attack and maybe keep this one back in the city to defend. This group could really use a longbow, though. Kind of lacking any good range units, so I'll send one with them. There, that makes for a pretty decent army, I think. Get a couple more reanimators underground to help this group ward off any attackers, and I think it should be in pretty good shape. In fact, I probably don't need all those units on that city. I may be able to send them out in a different direction to cause trouble somewhere, but only after I've got a reanimator for them. That archer I'm going to send straight underground to help defend this city, assuming that I eventually build it up, get a wall there, and leave some units behind to defend while I send that army out to attack, because I'm thinking I may have this army led by the new sorcerer hero that I'm going to get hopefully soon. That lost soul can't do much of anything useful here, so I will send it out to explore in a different direction. And, the Goblin Theocrat just completed the Centurion quest, which means he is the first to have 100 units, and all of his units instantly leveled up. He pretty much just became the number one threat this game, and we still haven't seen any of his units, have no clue where he is. He could pop up out of nowhere with a massive army and cause some real trouble, so getting those Chthonic Guardians is going to be a pretty high priority for me, as they're going to be really my only shot of fighting him, because they're going to be one of the few units that I have that are powerful that aren't undead. Alright, we are at the end of this turn, and we are at about the time to wrap this episode up, so the next episode should be pretty interesting. Evan will hopefully knock out White, which is going to be a big help for us, but it just became very clear to me that teal, or blue, whatever color he is a very serious problem that could be our main challenge overcoming him towards the end of this game. The Necromancer, I think, is pretty well under control. White is pretty well under control, and the Draconians haven't done much except send kind of a small army this direction that I'm pretty sure I could ward off with these units if it tried to attack my city. Alright, everyone, that pretty much wraps this one up. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to watch Evan's perspective of this game on his own channel. You can see his post-commentary and get a good sense for what's happening after the fact, after we've had some time to think things through. You can see the overworld map here, just a brief overview. Evan did sacrifice Engrenost here to White in the hope of killing White, which would be ultimately a lot better for us. Besides, Engrenost wasn't that great of a city anyway. I guess it had some decent resource income, but he should be able to get that back with these units that he's got in this area anyway. So overall, I think we're in pretty good position. Just gotta watch out for blue somewhere. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you in the next episode.